McConnell then made a full statement in which he admitted intending to shoot Dr. Miller. Apparently, he was convinced somehow that you were responsible for his mother's imprisonment and for the shootout in which his mate was killed.
What'll happen now?
He'll be charged on both counts of murder. He'll probably plead insanity.
And get off, you mean?
Oh, no, he's not a well lad, Mrs. McCauley. I doubt if he'll ever be released.
Greg, Mrs. McCauley, could I have a word with you, please? I need your permission to operate again.
But you said Karen's too weak.
She is, and I wouldn't want to operate under any other circumstances. But the fragments are moving closer to the heart. If we don't operate, she will most certainly die.
Janet, are you awake?
Janet?
Hello again.
I didn't wake you, did I?
No. I was just thinking.
So was I. What about?
Just things, generally. What about you?
Same here. Might as well be honest. I was thinking about you. You're the most interesting person I've met since I've been in here.
Thank you.
What do you think's going to happen? I mean, that man who died in the States. Will they take you back there for trial?
I doubt it.
Why?
Well, I have to be extradited from Australia first. And our cause has supporters here. And enough finance to get me the best lawyer available.
Oh, come off it, Janet.
How do you mean?
Well, the courts aren't going to support you. You've killed someone in America. Someone important. Janet, I want to escape. Why can't we help each other?
I mean, when we get out, we can go overseas. I've never been overseas.
Thanks, but I've told you. My people will look after me. Good night.
Thanks for the lift.
Pleasure.
Coming in for a minute?
Well, just for a minute. I won't stay.
Not even for a coffee?
Well, I shouldn't. I know you're tired, and I wouldn't want to wear out my welcome.
Oh, Leela's a wonderful cook, isn't she?
Hmm.
I'm sure you won't sit down.
Well, just for a moment.
Well, that's a definite no to coffee, then.
Well, I think it should be. Leela. I've always had a soft spot for the old girl.
Well, can I be rude and say it didn't seem mutual?
Oh, we're old sparring partners. It keeps us both on our toes.
Well, I was rather surprised to get an invitation.
Well, actually, I asked Jim to invite you. I hope you don't mind.
Oh, not at all. Thanks for the thought.
Good. I'd really like to do it again sometime. Maybe dinner and a show or something like that?
Well, I'm pretty busy at the moment.
Every night? Look, if you'd prefer not to go, just say so. I understand.
Well, perhaps I could change some plans for Saturday, but I'd have to check it and phone you.
Oh, that'd be great.
Oh, okay then, Jeff. Well, I'll be in touch.
Good.
Thanks for this evening.
Pleasure.
Goodbye.
Night, night.
Oh, is this disturbing you, Bea?
No, no worries, Lynn. Listen. Give us a hoy if the news comes on. There might be something about Karen.
Oh, I could tell you in the morning.
Look, love. I know if it's on the news, it's most likely going to be bad, but they might just happen to say she's all right. And I'd rather know. But like you with David.
And here is the latest news. There's still no word on the future of suspected terrorist Jeanette Dominguez, arrested early this morning at Tullamarine Airport. Dominguez is alleged to have planted a bomb at the United Nations building in New York, killing a senior South American diplomat. She's being held under tight security at Wentworth Detention Center, pending a decision on extradition.
It's a new woman in the town.
Police are expected to fly in from New York over the next 2 or 3 days to commence extradition proceedings. The hunt is over for prison escapee David O'Connell, alleged to have killed a policeman in a gun battle last week. Police recaptured O'Connell tonight after receiving a tip-off.
Ah, somebody shopped him.
In a new development, police have charged O'Connell with the attempted murder of Mrs. Karen Travers, who tonight is still in a critical condition in hospital. Travers was gunned down in the surgery of her fiancé, Dr. Greg Miller.
Oh, no. Quiet down, the rabbit. It's okay.
Police, country fire authority, and a gas and fuel...
Who is it?
Greg. Come. I'm sorry it's so late. I saw your light on.
Oh, come in, come in.
I don't mean to disturb you.
It's all right. Sit down. I'll get you a drink.
Well, just one, eh? I had to operate again.
How is she?
She's out of the theatre, just hanging on. I had to get out and drive around a bit. Thanks. I'm sorry to barge in.
It's okay, don't worry.
I couldn't think of anyone else to talk to.
Look, she's going to be all right.
It's too early to tell. It's her second major op in 24 hours.
Look, she'll pull through. But you've got to start thinking about yourself. You're just pushing it too hard. You'll collapse.
No, I'll be okay.
Look, why don't you stay here and get a few hours' sleep? You can ring the hospital, leave them my number.
No, I'm okay. I just needed a friendly face, that's all. Look, I want to check back at the hospital. There's a motel opposite. I'll go in there, I promise.
Fine, but if there's anything I can do...
Yeah, thanks. Thanks.
Take care.
Janet Dominguez is becoming a problem. The department were on the phone to me the minute I arrived this morning. Apparently the group she's with has issued a statement. They're threatening reprisals because of her imprisonment.
What sort of reprisals?
Well, nobody knows, but the department still wants maximum security. She's to remain in solitary for as long as she's here.
Well, I think that's reasonable under the circumstances.
I agree, but it might make her more difficult to handle.
We'll manage.
Yes. Oh, Officer Phillip is supervising breakfast for Dominguez. How does she seem?
I'm quite relaxed. She ate everything, even thanked us when we took the plates.
Well, maybe she's waiting for something to happen.
I wouldn't be surprised. We'll just have to keep our eyes open. Yes?
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's all right, Dr. Miller. How's Karen? I heard they had to operate.
Yes, she's hanging on.
You look very tired.
No, I'm fine. I got into a motel room, had a few hours' sleep there.
Well, I expect you'll need a few days off. We can manage, but if anything happens, I can get in a GP.
Mrs. Davidson, I'd rather work. I need something to take my mind off what's happened.
Well, of course.
In fact, I'd like to start right away, if that's okay.
Well, I've cancelled the sick call. It was only the usual hypochondriacs anyway.
There must be something. I really need to work. I'll go back to my own surgery, but the window and the telephone, they've not been fixed.
Mrs. Davidson, there's Dominguez. New admissions, the
Oh,
medical.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Janet Dominguez...
Oh, yes, I heard on the radio.
Well, she's in solitary. You'll have to examine her there.
Oh, that's fine.
Mr. Fletcher and Officer Phillip will go with you. Who are you?
I'm the prison doctor. I have to give you a routine examination.
Why didn't this happen when I was admitted?
Because I wasn't here. Sit down, please.
I'm afraid I don't have much faith in prison doctors. One examined my husband regularly while he was being tortured, then wrote natural causes on the death certificate.
So we do things differently here.
Really? I hadn't noticed.
That's enough.
It's all right.
Oh, I know you, Doctor. The obligatory Mr. Kindness. You're part of the window dressing. When did you last try to change anything here, except perhaps your salary? What do you really do for the masses, the ones who pay for it?
You're so concerned about the masses. When did you last think about the innocent people that get killed in the crossfire?
All the time, Doctor. But when force is used against you, you have to use force in reply.
And to hell with who gets hurt. I think I'll continue this examination later. She seems perfectly healthy, physically anyway.
Sorry if I made you think a little, Doctor.
Ready.
Just the sort of medical attention I'd expected. Cursory and disinterested.
Some of this stuff in now, save time later.
Don't waste any time, do you?
Hey, come on, Leela, it's me, Jeff.
You don't have to remind me.
Well, Jim invited me. What could I say?
You could have said no.
I would have, if I'd known you were going to get so sore about it.
As long as you realize you're his guest and not mine.
Come on, I'm only here for a short time. What do you got against me anyway?
Times change, Jeff, and so do people. Jim's army days have gone forever, and the sooner he realizes that, the better for everyone.
Well, don't point out Jim's problems to me, honey.
And don't call me honey.
That's the old Leela I always knew. Bites like a tiger snake.
What did you say you did for a living these days?
I'm an insurance executive.
So why aren't you out working at 10 o'clock in the morning?
I'm a senior insurance executive. I work a lot of evenings and take time off during the day.
Well, I hope you like going to movies.
Oh, I do. Is there anything you'd like to see?
No, but it'll keep you out of my hair until Jim gets home.
So... there was this poor old man dying in the street. I couldn't just run away and leave him. So I asked somebody to call an ambulance. You know what she did? She recognized me and called the cops. I mean, it didn't matter that the old man was dying.
Right. Bourgeois morality. Protect their own interests first.
And he did die. So I might as well have left him there in the first place.
At your age, I'd have done exactly what you did. Now I know better.
Dr. Miller must be furious the way you put him down.
Those people, they're the dupes of the system and they don't even know it. Before, when you offered to help me, were you serious?
Well, of course I was.
How serious?
What do you want me to do?
We're an army, involved in a war. It's a matter of following orders.
It's not quite as simple as that. When you go, I want to go with you.
I think that's reasonable. You seem our kind of person.
And I'll need to know what's going on.
Our organization doesn't work that way. Everyone knows only what's necessary. So if anybody's captured by the other side, they can only tell what they know. Do you see that?
Yeah, I suppose so.
An organization like ours works on loyalty to the cause and to each other. I give you my word I'll look after you. That's all I can offer.
What do I have to do?
Tell me the name of one of your friends at school. Anyone at all.
Why? Sandra Thompson.
Don't be surprised if you receive a visit soon.
What, from Sandra?
Have you ever been interested in politics before?
No, not really.
I'll have to educate you.
What's going on?
Talking.
What about?
We're just passing the time.
All right, come on. Exercise. Time for your exercise. Come on. That way.
Officers standing around because a murderess wants to take a walk. Well, if it was up to me, I'd... Oh, here they come now. Stay here and keep your eyes open.
Screws everywhere. You've really got them scared.
They're always scared. They know the people won't put up with it much longer. Thick as thieves, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure we should let Coulson mix with that one.
What's going on over there?
Oh, it looks like a visitor.
Find out who he is and what he wants. I'm not taking any chances with her out here.
In my country, the army took over. It was violent.
And violence is the only answer the working class has.
I'd hardly call you working class.
You see, you're thinking just like them. A working class are permitted to have an education too, you know.
His name's John Pendleton. He wants to see Dominguez. He's her lawyer.
Did you check his ID?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I did.
Take him to the interview room. I'll escort her inside.
How long before something happens?
It could be very soon. So be ready.
Yes?
B. Smith wants to see you about Karen Travers?
Sharon.
Smith?
Is there any news, Mrs. Davidson?
According to Dr. Miller, it's still touch and go.
Oh. Well, we'd taken up a collection for an engagement present. Well, now we'd like to spend on some flowers.
It's very commendable of you, Smith.
We're keeping a bit of it, though, just in case we have to buy a wreath.
Of course. Well, if you leave the money with me, I'll see that reception arranges the flowers.
It's $8.90. Oh, look, there's one other thing. Well, some of the girls are due for release soon. And with Karen not being there, well, we're wondering if the halfway house is going to close.
Angela Jeffries contacted me about that. The halfway house will remain open. Miss Jeffries herself will keep an eye on things.
Well, it's nice to hear something's going all right for a change.
It is indeed.
Can we beat the extradition in court?
I doubt it. The Americans are sending two top men. They're out to get you.
How long will it take?
Smart Money is saying you'll be back in New York in a week.
So we forget the courts. What else?
Well, we could launch an appeal through the British consulate, try and stir up some publicity.
The British government fight the Americans over me, forget it.
There isn't too much else we can do.
There's a hell of a lot you can do. It's time you people did a bit more than hand out pamphlets and write on walls. There's a girl in here who's prepared to help me escape. Her name's Rosalind Coulson.
You can't use an outsider in that kind of operation. It's too dangerous.
We don't have any choice. They're keeping me in solitary. Someone else has to organize
this. Look, I still don't think...
John! Our girl's called Rosalind Coulson. Got that? She has a school friend called Sandra Thompson, now aged about 17. You'll need a girl that age using that name as the go-between. Oh, and one other thing. If Coulson helps, we're going to take her with us.
Why?
Because I promised her. I think she'll be an asset.
I'll report to the others, see what they think.
I'm sure they'll agree with me. Or else my friends overseas will be asking questions.
Call the officer.
And John, thanks for everything.
Hello, Meg.
Hello, Angela. Who are you here to see?
Pat O'Connell about her appeal.
I'll just clear it with the governor. Mrs. Davidson, Angela Jeffries here to see Pat O'Connell about her appeal. Right. Yes, that's fine. That was a terrible shock, Pat's son shooting Karen.
Yes, it was.
You don't seem terribly upset.
Meg, I'm dealing with people's misfortunes every day. Emotion is a luxury I can't allow myself. I can't afford it.
I'll show you to the interview room.
For God's sake, Pat, you're not accountable for David's actions. Pat, look at me.
Well, he's my son.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Don't you care about your other children? It's them we've got to worry about now. And it's for them that I have got to get you out of jail. Now, you say that all the time David was on the run, you never saw him. This friend of his just turned up with the Christmas presents.
I just found them on the back doorstep.
Well, who'd be aware of that?
Just my mother. She was the only one there.
Good. I'll talk to her. I'll be in touch.
Angela, can you tell me who's defending David?
I am.
What are his chances? Honestly.
Two psychologists are examining him. One for the Crown, one for us. When our man reports, then I'll decide how we're going to plead.
In the meantime, Pat, you've got to forget about David. You've got to concentrate on your other children and yourself.
Well, there we are. Finished dinner and didn't mention the army once. Remember that old CO we used to have, old Hanley?
Oh, yeah.
Couldn't talk about anything else.
How's work at the prison? Did you know that Karen Travers who was shot?
Yep.
How's Greg Miller taking it?
Well, not too well, according to Meg Jackson. Apparently he called her last night, very upset.
They must be good friends, an old romantic attachment.
Could still be current, I'd say.
Well, I don't know about that. She's going out with me on Saturday night. I'll get it. I'm expecting a call.
Do you think it's a good idea letting Meg get involved with Jeff?
Oh, come on, Leela. She's a grown woman. Why don't you just mind your own business?
Well, I've got to go out. You'll be sorry to hear. Business. I'll see you later.
You're right, man. I'd better fix that mudguard on Nicky's bike.
Hello, Meg Jackson.
Oh, it's Leela Fletcher here, Meg, Jim's wife.
Hello, Leela, how are you?
Look, just a word of warning in confidence between you and I. I believe you're going out with Jeff Butler next week. I'd be very careful about getting involved with him.
What do you mean?
He's just a little strange, that's all. Look, please don't tell Jim I phoned. He hates me interfering.
Said I've got those.
Oh, you look tired enough as it is.
Oh, thanks.
Well, she's held on for 24 hours. She's going to be all right.
Oh, I don't know. There's a dozen things that go wrong yet.
Oh, you're a born pessimist.
Just careful, Mary. Just careful.
Greg, if something's wrong, I'd rather know.
Dr. Downing.
No, it's nothing.
Greg?
Well, it's just that she should have regained consciousness by now.
Any specific cause for alarm?
No, none that I know of.
Well, Karen's always been a fighter. She's been at death's door twice and come back. And she's going to be all right now. Have you two thought where you're going to live after you get married?
It's a bit early for that yet.
Oh, nonsense. Why don't you move to Queensland? I mean, you could buy a practice up there and start a new life. Get away from all this.
You know, that may not be such a bad idea. Karen's going to need plenty of rest.
Somewhere on the Darling Downs would be best. Oh, that's beautiful country.
Well, I think we'd better discuss it with Karen first.
I think she'd like the idea. Anything you want, that'd be fine with her.
Dr.
You do like the idea, don't you?
Dr. McIntyre.
Yes. Yes, as a matter of fact, I do.
Well, that's settled. Now, my Charles is a state manager, and he can be a lot of help to you up there relocating yourselves. I always knew that husband of mine would come in handy one day.
Who is it?
Jeff Butler. I was just passing. Everything okay?
Sure. Come in.
Thanks. I'm not disturbing you.
No. You sit down.
Thanks a lot. I was in the neighbourhood, just clinched a big business deal. Feeling pretty pleased with myself, as a matter of fact, so I thought maybe we should go out and celebrate.
Not tonight, thanks, Jeff.
Well, it's not every day I clinch a deal like this.
Tell me about it.
Well, it's pretty technical, really. Let's just say it's worth celebrating.
Well, actually, I was waiting for a phone call from the hospital about Karen, so I'd rather not go out.
Oh, I see.
But if you're celebrating, why not have a drink here? I mean, I can't have a late night because I've got a very heavy day tomorrow.
Well, if you're sure you've got time.
Sure. Scotch?
Thanks, no water.
How's Leela?
Oh, fine. Still sparring.
Why doesn't she like you?
Well, actually, it's not me she doesn't like. It's the army. The demands it makes on a man. The man, of course, being Jim. Thanks. Well, here's to our first million. Each.
On a prison officer's wages?
Why not?
Well, you know what daughters are like about their mothers.
You've got it all worked out, haven't you?
Well, believe me, she's going to want me around once you start your family.
Dr. McIntyre to reception, please. Dr. McIntyre.
How are you, Greg? I was just passing, thought I'd pop in and see how Karen is.
Hello, Angela. This is Mrs. Macaulay, Karen's mother. Mrs. Macaulay, Angela Jeffries.
Oh, yes, Karen mentioned you in her letters. You started the halfway house, didn't you?
I'm pleased to meet you, Mrs. Macaulay. What's the news?
Well, still not good. She hasn't regained consciousness.
She'll be all right.
Thank you. It was good of you to drop by.
Actually, I wanted to ask you something. Pat O'Connell, I'm appearing for her at her appeal. You could help a great deal by appearing as a witness.
Angela, do you have any idea where you are? Karen is in a room down there fighting for her life because of Pat O'Connell. Oh,
calm down, Greg. This won't do any good.
Greg, what's done is done. What happened to Karen is no fault of Pat's. And she desperately needs your help.
No, Angela. If you want me, you can serve me with a subpoena.
For the sort of evidence we need, that would be useless.
Yes, it would be.
If you change your mind, you know where to find me. I'm sorry, Mrs. Macaulay.
Nurse Watson required...
God, her sense of timing. She must practice for hours.
It's all over now.
How is she?
She's just recovered consciousness, Doctor.
Can we see her?
Just for a few moments. She's very weak.
Mary? Yes.
Everything's going to be all right.
It's true. Doctor's orders.
You just concentrate on getting better as soon as possible.
It's fine.
Dr. Miller.
Oh, yes, nurse, right away. Now you get some sleep. It's all going to be fine.
So there I was, crouched in a ditch, soaked to the skin, not three paces from an RSM who's threatening to flay my hide and nail it to the wall.
Well, what did you do then?
I knew that he couldn't actually prove it was me he'd seen. You see, it was pretty dark. So I knew my one chance was to beat him back to base and then deny I'd ever been AWOL. The only problem was, he had a jeep and I was on foot.
Which gave him a pretty big advantage.
Right. So what I did was I snuck around behind the jeep and let down one of his tyres with a pen. So I bolted back to the camp while he changed the tyre in the dark and I beat him home by 5 minutes.
Another drink?
Why not?
Oh, would you mind getting?
Love to.
Hello?
Hi, it's me.
Oh, Greg, how's Karen?
She's going to be okay.
Oh, Greg, that's wonderful.
I feel as if the weight of the world's off my shoulders.
Now, what you've got to do is go home and sleep for 2 days.
That's exactly how I feel. Meg, I just want to say thank you again. Friend in need and all that.
My pleasure. And I'm sure Karen will be back on her feet in no time.
She will be. See you at work tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Good news?
Yes. Karen's going to be all right.
You've known Greg long?
Sure. But we're just good friends.
Oh, it's none of my business.
Well, where were we? Oh, I remember. You just avoided having your backside nailed to the wall.
Yeah, look at that, eh? 10:30. I know you've got a big day tomorrow, and so have I, so I've really enjoyed it, Meg. It's been a lot of fun.
Oh, that's okay.
I'll see you on Saturday, then, eh?
Fine.
Thanks again. Night.
Bye.
Well, Coulson, have you learnt your lesson? Or isn't 4 days long enough?
Yes, Miss Bennet.
Well, you've come down a peg or two. Now, come on, back to the laundry.
Miss Bennet, what about B. Smith?
What about her?
I told the governor on her.
It so happens we're aware of your little feud with Smith. We'll be keeping an eye on things. And the governor has decided to give you a new cellmate.
Who?
Come on.
Please.
Kathleen Leach, seeing you ask so nicely. But you should be very grateful, Coulson, that we didn't leave you to spend tonight with Smith before the changeover. Come on.
Can I say goodbye to Janet through the door?
You certainly can't. Now, come on.
Bye, Janet.
I'm warning you. Just be careful or you'll end up back in the pound.
Oh, look, come on, love, buck up. It's the waiting, Bee. You've got to learn to put all that behind you. You've got to think about your own trial and your other kids.
Oh, that's what everyone keeps telling me.
Well, maybe because it's right. Well, don't you love your other kids?
Of course I do. But how do you expect me to stop loving David?
Oh, I'll do that for you.
Oh, it's all right, Kath. I'm okay.
What are you lot standing around for? Get back to work.
Oh, sorry, Vera, but no one told us you was coming. Hello, Roz.
How are you?
Leach? You and Coulson will be sharing a cell together. Coulson, you help Leach fold those sheets.
Good to see you, Ross.
Any trouble from you, Smith, and you're in for it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Miss Bennet.
Hey, that terrace woman was in solitary. Did you get to talk to her?
I got to know her quite well.
Did she really murder that bloke in America?
Of course she did. Except that it wasn't murder. It was an act of war.
An act of war?
Well, it was.
Oh, come off it, love. Listen, when I killed my old man, that was an act of war too. But it was also murder. And I didn't make any fancy excuses.
He basically wants the same things we do. A better deal for the working people. Just fighting the capitalist system. Oh, you wouldn't understand.
Right, I want two people for cleaning duty. You, Kath, and you, Pauline.
Can I work with Kath, Mrs. Jackson?
You're volunteering to scrub floors.
Well, I'd rather not work in the laundry.
Well, I'm sure Pauline won't mind. Well, move along.
That kid just loves trouble.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Bought you some furs.
Thank you.
How are you?
Well, I think I'm improving. I'm starting to feel uncomfortable.
That's a good sign. Got a long way to go yet.
Look, I'm flying back to Queensland this afternoon, but I'm going to speak to Charles, and I want you and Greg to join us as soon as you're out of hospital.
Oh, that'd be nice.
Well, I'll go and find Sister and get her to put these in water.
Thanks, ma'am.
Do you know how good it is to see you looking so much better?
I've been waiting to see you all morning.
No more problems now, I promise. We're going to lead quiet, reputable lives.
Greg,
mm-hmm.
Can I ask you something? I'm going to be scarred, aren't I? I'll dye my side and on my face.
Karen, my darling, that's the least of our worries. I'm just grateful to have you. Besides, that can be taken care of with skin grafts.
Really?
Yes.
I hope you don't think I'm being vain or stupid. I guess, under the circumstances, I'm just lucky to be alive.
It's a perfectly normal reaction.
Thanks. Greg?
Mm-hmm.
I love you.
I love you, too. Hey, got some news for you. Put the practice on the market this morning.
Already?
Don't get excited. It's not the most salubrious practice in town. We may have to wait a while. But I'll give Erica my notice. And by the time you're out of here, we'll be able to go to Queensland together.
Well, I better tell Angela pretty soon.
Oh, you'll have no problem there. The halfway house, I'm amazed to say, is carrying on quite happily without you.
She's a really terrific person. Bea and Pat could never understand her. They're too old.
Yeah?
You never change people like them. I wish you could meet her. I think you'd like her.
Well, one thing's for sure. I'm not going to go to the pound just to find out.
Oh, don't worry. She won't be in there for too much longer.
How come? Is she going to escape?
She didn't say.
Oh, come on, Roz, I won't tell nobody.
You got a visitor, Coulson? Someone called Sandra Thompson.
From school? Oh, great.
Yeah, well, that trip may be a bucket, eh?
Sandra!
Hi, Roz.
Oh, it's great to see you. Sit down. What did you do to your arm?
Oh, it's my hand, actually. Oh, it's nothing serious. One of my boyfriends had an accident in his car.
Oh,
it's just inconvenient. It means I can't write.
Uh-huh. You're always writing at school, aren't you? Essays and stuff.
Oh, still do a bit. Well, I don't get much too time for it these days, though.
Mm.
We had time for everything then.
Didn't we ever?
Do you remember that time we put that laxative in the urn?
In the staff common room.
Oh, yeah, sure I did.
And the place was deserted for days.
Oh, and do you remember Mr. Veen, our Spanish teacher?
Uh-huh.
I ran into her the other day, and she wanted to know how you were.
Oh.
And when I told her, she'd ask if you'd write to her.
Oh, I will.
Oh, would you need her address?
Yes, I'm afraid I do. She moved, didn't she?
Mm, that's right. Excuse me, I can't write. My hand? Can I give Roz a pen and paper so she can take down the address?
Yes, of course.
Q?
At 14 Jones Street, Kensington. I can't remember the postcode.
Oh, that's okay. I can look that up. Thanks.
How are you finding it in here, anyway?
Oh, it takes a bit of getting used to.
Do you remember our dorm at school? When you always used to sleep under the window. Do they let you have a window in your cell?
Of course they do. It's primitive, but it's not that bad.
Do you have a good view?
Oh, fine. Except when the sun comes up in the morning, it shines in. Wakes me up.
Oh, it's a bit hard to take.
Mm.
You always were a night owl. Well, I better be going. Oh, and don't forget to write to Mr. Veen. She'd really love to hear from you.
Well, it's great to see you.
Thanks very much.
You must have come back here. What's that?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just some bits and pieces Sandra left for me.
I know what it is. She's a friend of Janet's, isn't she? And this is all part of your escape.
Shut up, will you?
Oh, come on, Roz. You know I can keep my mouth shut.
Right. I'm going to escape with Janet. Her friends are tough, Kathleen. If you let on anything about this, they'll send someone here to kill you, just like they killed that man in New York.
You can trust me, Roz. But how the hell are you gonna do it?
Well, day after I get the signal, I have to drop these capsules into the officer's coffee urn by 3 p.m. The time release capsules. How's that for organization? They can make the screws go to sleep whenever they want them to.
What's the signal?
Note says I have to watch for flashing headlights every night.
Oh, gee, Roz.
She wanted to know which side of the prison my window was on. I let her know it was on the east side, right under Fletcher's nose.
Roz, are you sure you should be with this mob? I mean, bombs and stuff.
They can do anything they want. Everybody's scared of them. Besides, anything's better than being locked up in here.
Good morning, Kathleen.
Good, I be.
Just a sec, Roz. What do you want to go getting yourself transferred out the laundry for?
I just wanted to, that's all.
Look, I'm just trying to help.
Well, I don't need your help.
Well, suit yourself. But you told Vera yesterday that I'm being threatening you, right? Oh, now, come on, love. I don't have to be mandrake to work that one out.
What's got into you?
Oh, just leave me alone.
Wake up to yourself, Roz.
Smith? You're warned, Smith.
I don't know. What you're talking about?
Intimidating Coulson.
She was not, Miss Bennet.
Just stay out of this, Leech. Well, it looks as if I arrived just in time, Coulson.
We were just talking.
You were threatening her. Right, Coulson?
We were just talking, Miss Bennet.
I was right about you, Coulson. You're not worth worrying about. But there are rules. And I'm watching you, Smith.
Mm.
Now get a move on, the three of you.
Leela took off in a hurry?
Yeah, she had to take the kids to school.
Yeah. Jim, do you think it'd be better if I moved out?
No. Forget it. I'm not going to have Leela think that she can pressure me by behaving like a child. It'll never stop.
Yeah, well, I shouldn't be here for much longer anyway. What do you know about this Greg... What's his name?
Miller?
Yeah.
Why?
I just wondered. I was driving past Meg's place last night. Called in to say hello, and while I was there, Greg rang. They seem quite friendly.
They are?
Yeah.
Look, Jeff, how serious are you about Meg?
Oh, God, Jim, you sound like a father. She's a good sort, that's all.
Oh, she is. You could do a lot worse. Yeah, there used to be something between her and Greg, but then Karen Travis came along.
This Karen must be quite a lady. Maybe I should open up a second front.
Morning, Wendy.
Good morning, Dr. Miller. I'm glad Karen's okay.
Oh, thanks.
Greg, I thought it was you I saw. I wanted to apologize about the other night, about Pat O'Connell. It was very tactless of me. I can only say that I've been very busy and I hope you'll forgive me.
Well, I've been thinking about it myself. Flying off the handle like that, it's not really me.
I know that.
And I do realize that it's hardly Pat's fault if her son breaks the law. Even if...
I know what you mean.
Well, if you want me to give evidence, that's okay.
Pat will be very grateful.
Fine. Well, I'd better be getting on with it.
I'll see you later, and thanks.
Good morning, Miss Jeffries.
Good morning. Can I see Pat O'Connell?
Okay, smoke out. How's cleaning duty going?
Why do I always get jobs like that?
Don't worry. It'll only last another day or two, if you keep your nose clean. How's it going? Look, come on, love. Seeing as I know how you like to worry, why not worry about something new for a change? Roz, how's she getting on?
Okay, I guess. But anyone who likes washing floors has got to be a bit crazy.
She's not crazy. She's a bit too smart for her own good, if you ask me, eh, Pat? Can't accept the responsibilities of life from the inside.
A lot of young people have that problem.
Yeah, well, we're dealing with one at a time. At the moment, it's Roz. She's up to something. What? Oh, now, come on. Don't you play silly buggers with me, Kath. It's another escape plan, right?
Yeah, right.
There, told you. Some people will never learn. How's she going to do it?
Oh, I don't know. She hasn't worked out her plans yet.
There's nothing much we can do.
No, except keep an eye on her. Keep us informed, eh?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, aren't you supposed to be on cleaning duty?
Yeah, just having a break, Mrs. Jackson.
You got a visitor, Pat. Angela Jeffries. Come on, back to work.
It'll be all right, love. Sure.
I'll be outside.
Sit down, Pat. Any news about David? Bad news. I've received the psychological assessments. His mind's been affected, which probably means he can beat the murder charge. But the net result is that he'll be held in a mental institution at the governor's pleasure.
For how long?
There's strong doubt that he'd ever be released. Pat, I've spoken to your mother and to Dr. Miller, and they're both prepared to give evidence for you. So, provided we can get a sympathetic court, I'm confident the appeal will be upheld.
Thanks.
I'm sorry. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
Bea's worked out that you're planning to escape.
I didn't tell her anything about your friends.
Well, you better not have. What did you say?
That you hadn't worked your plans out yet.
Good.
She's only worried about you, Roz.
Well, she needn't worry about me. She'll still be locked up in here when I'm miles away. I'll send you a postcard from Paris.
Blast. I wonder if they'll signal tonight. Roz, I've been thinking about that powder stuff. I mean, the drugs. Well, how do you know that's really what it is?
What do you want about?
When you put it in the coffee urn, how do you know it's just going to put the screws to sleep? It might be poison.
Poison?
They're terrorists. They've killed people before. And what if Janet dumps you and you've got to take the rap for killing half the screws?
Janet wouldn't do that.
Says who?
She wouldn't. I'll prove it.
Don't!
See?
Are you feeling okay?
Well, I'm fine. Now stop worrying.